bookmark, our gift to you and reminder that as you start your new class this week, you're not alone. Thank you, guys. Okay. Spoiler alert. The titles of the sermons today and next week have a certain similarity and a certain symmetry, and that's by design. Today is the Word of God for the people of God. Next week is the love of God for the people of God. And in each of these sermons, you're going to hear a double meaning that we'll talk about in just a moment. One is the word of the love of God for us, each of us, the people of God. The second meaning is each of us, all of us, as the word or the love of God for the people of God beyond these walls. In other words, the people of God's creation, the whole world. I'd like us to listen for that double meaning as we listen to the story of Jeremiah, a reluctant prophet called into duty as a youth when he knew, he just knew, he wasn't qualified for that role. I invite us to listen for the word of God. Jeremiah 1, verse 4 and following. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. Then I said, ah, Lord God, truly I do not know how to speak, for I'm only a boy. But the Lord said to me, do not say I'm only a boy, for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and you shall speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said to me, now I put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms, to pluck up and to pull down, to destroy and overthrow, to build and to plant. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks.
Thanks be to God. Let's pray. Lord, may we truly feel your word of God touched upon